This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. All right, this is part three of how to prove an equation is not an identity, and we're working with trig equations. So we're going to do this problem. Show that the following equation is not an identity. Cosine of x equals the square root of 1 minus sine squared x. All right, now, this is not an identity because we're being asked to show that. Some people look at this and they think it is an identity. Because they might think, well, I'm just going to square both sides. And what happens when you square both sides? You would get cosine squared x. And when you square the other side, you would get 1 minus sine squared x. And then if I add sine squared x to both sides, I have sine squared x plus cosine squared x equals 1. And this is an identity. This is an identity. So you may think, well, if this is an identity, why isn't this other one an identity? And the reason is when you square something, it changes the equation. It's not exactly the same equation. Remember, when you square both sides of an equation, you always have to check your solutions, for instance. All right, so that being said, that means there must be some value of x. It's not going to make this true. And we have to find one. So let's just try anything. Let's try 0. Let's see what happens. I like to use 0 and see what happens, if I can. So if x equals 0, the left-hand side would be the cosine of 0, which is, all right, so remember what, if we had 0, this is 1, that order pair 1, 0. The cosine is the x-coordinate, so that would be 1. And the right-hand side would be the square root of 1 minus, now the sine squared x means the sine of x, right, which is the sine of 0 squared, which is, all right, now what's the sine of 0? The sine of 0 is 0, because it's the y-coordinate over here at this order pair 1, 0. And so we have the square root of 1 minus 0 squared, so that will give you the square root of, well, 1 minus 0 squared is 1 minus 0, which is 1, and the square root of 1 is 1. Okay, well, we got the same number on both sides, so that's not the example that's going to help us show that it's not an identity. Okay, so back to the drawing board. Let's pick something else. If you want to pick something else, maybe in quadrant 1. How about pi over 4? Let's try pi over 4. All right, so at pi over 4, remember, it's 1 squared of 2. All right, so the left-hand side is the cosine of pi over 4. So the cosine of pi over 4, that would be 1 over square roots of 2. Now, I know that simplifies, but for now, I'm just going to leave it as 1 over square roots of 2. And the right-hand side is the square root of 1 minus the sine of pi over 4 squared. All right, so this is a little more complicated. That's the square root of 1 minus, all right, what's the sine of pi over 4? Well, it's also 1 over square roots of 2. And then I'm going to square that. So what does this give me? It's a little more space. That's 1 minus, all right. So I'm squaring 1 over square roots of 2. That's going to be 1 half. Square the numerator and denominator. And 1 minus 1 half is 1 half, so I have the square root of 1 half. And if you take the square root of that, square root of the top, square root of the bottom, I'm going to get 1 over square root of 2. Oh gosh. Again, I got the same thing on the left-hand side and the right-hand side. So pi over 4 wasn't a good choice either. Okay, back to the drawing board again. And this is what it's like sometimes. But you have to be persistent. Let's try a different quadrant. How about something in quadrant 2. Let's do 3 pi over 4. Okay. So here we are. I think if this is negative 1, 1, and square root of 2, everybody, you know, might get what the sine and cosine using some other method than me. Maybe you've memorized it. This is my way of figuring it out. So I'm going to put in 3 pi over 4 on the left-hand side. That's the cosine of 3 pi over 4. All right, what's the cosine of 3 pi over 4? It's the x over the r, so it's negative 1 over square root of 2. What's the right-hand side? The right-hand side was 1 minus the sine of 3 pi over 4, and I'm squaring it. So I still have this big square root, 1 minus. Now, what is the sine of 3 pi over 4? Okay, I'll look over here, and it's the y over the r, so it's 1 over square root of 2. And we're squaring that number. So that's the square root of 1 minus, well, 1 over square root of 2 squared is 1 half. You square the numerator, square the denominator. And that's the square root of 1 half, because that's what 1 minus 1 half is. And actually, you might have noticed this off the beginning. When you take the square root of something, you take the principal square root, it's never going to be negative. So this is going to be 1 over the square root of 2. It's going to be a positive number. So even before I figured all this out, I could tell that was going to happen because the right-hand side is the square root of something, so it's always going to be non-negative, where the cosine could end up being a negative number, the left-hand side. And so here is a value of x that shows that the left-hand side and the right-hand side are not equal, which means cosine of x equals square root of 1 minus sine squared x is not an identity. So we finish by writing our final sentence. Since the values of cosine x and square root of 1 minus sine squared x are not equal for x equals 3 pi over 4, the equation is not an identity. So keep plugging away. That's a little trick. Try a different quadrant. See if it has to do with the signs being positive or negative. That might be another way of showing something's not an identity if you keep trying numbers and you keep getting the same thing for the left-hand side and the right-hand side. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.